Friday, Courthouse Square. On a park bench, an old man was sitting there. I said, "Your old courthouse is kind of run down." He said, "Nah, it'll do for our little town." I said, "Your old flagpole has leaned a little bit. That's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it." He said, "Have a seat." And I sat down. "Is this the first time you've been to our little town?" I said, "I think it is." And he said, "Now, I don't like to brag. We're kind of proud of that ragged old flag." You see, we got a little hole in that flag there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key sat watching it and writing, "Oh, say, can you see?" And it got a bad rip in New Orleans with Packingham and Jackson tugging at its seams. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag. She waved on, though. She got cut with the sword at Chancellorsville. She got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a birthday gun. She turned blood red in World War II, and she hung limp and low a time or two. She was in Korea and Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now they've about quit waving her back here at home. In her own good land, here, she's been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, and refused. And the government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. She's getting threadbare and she's wearing thin, but she's in good shape for the shape she's in. Cause she's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning and we take her down every night. We don't let her touch the ground and we fold her upright. On second thought, I do like to brag, cause I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag. Thank you.